Students now see one small example, all well known example. Yes, suppose now you are driving one vehicle or sitting in any vehicle. You are all now moving. Suppose now in front of your vehicle, any vehicle coming or any person is there. Yes, you can see directly that particular vehicle or the vehicle person. But suppose students know rear side, that is back side any vehicle or any object is there. So to observe that, you should not now turn back side because your concentration should be on the forward. But how you observe now that back side now objects or vehicles or any persons? Yes, now this all vehicle now equipped with now mirrors, side mirrors. In that side mirror, either driver or the persons now will observe the backside vehicles. That means now in that mirror, the driver observing one particular now object. But students know that is not exact object. That is only image of the object presented to backside. That means now the driver observing the image and estimating the object location. This is now daily usage. So because of the daily usage now, he know, yes, here image visible means, yes, object somewhere. That means the driver know the relation between image and the object. That means what is the object location, object size, and object to speed, all now he can analyze, he can estimate. By using that, he can now proceed further. So that means the student here one important point. By using our image all parameters, image description, we need to estimate object description. That is object parameter, object to place, object to position, object to size, object to speed. This all we need to analyze. So now the relation between object to parameter and image parameter. Parameters means sizes, positions, speeds, accelerations. This all nothing but now parameters. So suppose now all image parameters we need. From the image parameter, object to parameters we need one of us. Suppose object to parameters we know, image parameters we need one of us. This relation, the relation between parameters of object and images, that all relations will be known or discussed or dealt in our present chapter, geometrical optics or simply ray optics. Yes, so students, now our main topic, ray optics or geometrical optics. Geometrical optics. Yes, so students, here the title now optics. That means here, whatever may be now visible light is there in our electromagnetic spectrum, visible light. So our eyes are sensitive to only that particular part of electromagnetic spectrum. So that all light rays now here we are dealing, that is the optics. And now come to ray optics or geometrical optics. So students, in that ray optics, yes, before going to that, one small theory here now I need to introduce. That is Newton's particle theory of light. According to Newton's particle theory of light, students, this light, whatever may be electromagnetic waves now, this electromagnetic light, this light, that is energy, that is moving in the form of small, small particles, almost massless particles. These particles are moving in rectilinear, that means straight lines. Indirectly, rectilinear propagation of light explained by the Newton. Yes, according to that, the path taken by light ray in a non-disturbed medium. So that path is known as a ray, students. That is the ray. So that analysis here now we are taking. That's why this optics is a ray optics. And the students here, the path taken by light ray, that is nothing but a straight line. That means here we are utilizing the properties of straight lines present in our mathematics. That is coordinate geometry. Straight lines, points, coordinates. This all now here we utilize. So that's why students here another name given, that is a geometrical optics. So ray optics, geometrical optics, here in both, here we are taking yes, a simple theory, that is Newton's particle theory of light, rectilinear propagation of light. So this is now introduction to our ray optics or geometrical optics. That means here, the Newton's particle theory clubbed with our mathematics geometry. So both now move one by one, parallel. Geometry and also our rectilinear propagation. Yes, now students come to our main topic. In this now, geometrical optics, light rays, that is particles are moving in a straight line. Yes, during that motion students, yes, one particle moving from one point to another point in a straight line path. Until and unless, no any disturbance, no problem. Suppose student now this particle is disturbed by any object. Or any boundary, whatever may be that obstacle, any disturbance is there, then definitely students, this particle deviate its path. So this disturbance, yes, maybe at the time of disturbance, a strong collision might happen, or maybe a small deviation may be happen. Yes, a strong collision, nothing but students' reflection. Yes, suppose now our straight line path, a small deviation. Yes, that may be entered from one medium to another medium. That is also one type of disturbance. That is nothing but a refraction. So students now know any disturbances. Yes, these light particles will move in a straight line. That is nothing but rectilinear propagation. No disturbance, a simply straight line. Suppose any disturbance is there. There may be reflection or may be refraction. Yes, now first we'll deal with now reflection. Yes, students all know. Suppose one cricket ball is coming now in a straight path. Yes, by using either bat or any some object. Yes, we can deviate that. Nothing but now due to, with the help of a collision, we are deviating that path. So same way here, by using now some object, maybe that may be mirror, by using one reflecting surface, this light, that means massless particles may be reflected. So that is now reflection of light. That is our present topic now. Yes, because of now this objection, yes, after reflection, what happened? Yes, before reflection, these light rays coming from where? After reflection, these light rays where go? What will be formed? That is our present discussion. Yes, so students here, geometrical optics main meaning now, that is the relation between objects parameter and the image parameter. So this object and the image. So technically now we need to know. So general and daily examples we know object to images. But technically what is the object? What is the image? So technically we completed that. Now coming to what is the object and what is the image? Yes, so students now here one small example. Yes, here one mirror is there. Yes, now I am the object. Now I am seeing now my image in that. That means here, students, this now complete reflecting surface. Now it is a forming one image. So now I am the object. My image is formed in that. So this all you know. But technically, what is the object to what is the image? Yes, so students, now here, one image is formed. Now object also there. But here one procedure is there. See now, first, yes, I am in the presence of the light. In my room now, light is there. That light incident on me, that means I am the object. So after that, light rays moving away from me. That light rays moving away from me, and after moving away from me, these light rays incident on the mirror. So after incident on the mirror, that light rays reflected back. Then later image is formed. That means, students, here object is related to the light rays before incident on the mirror. But image formed due to light rays after reflection from the mirror. That means here, object related to before the mirror, that means before reflection concept. Yes, after reflection, that is image. That means here, light rays also, two different now sets we have. One light ray set is an incident, means before reflection. That means before incident on the mirror, these are incident rays. After incident, now there is a reflected rays. So incident rays related to object. Reflected rays related to image. So now object is nothing but it is a point of divergence of light rays, students. Now remember, please. Yes, object is nothing but point of divergence. Means from the object only light rays all are moving away. So point of divergence of incident light rays. That is nothing but now here object. Students, now coming to the image. Yes, image is related to reflected rays. In the present topic, reflection. Next topic, refraction. That is different. Yes, now image is related to point of convergence of reflected rays. Not incident rays. That is reflected rays. So now here, point of divergence, point of convergence. Now two points. Okay. Point of divergence of incident rays is nothing but object, students. And point of convergence of reflected light rays is nothing but, in our present example, it is an image. Yes, now point of divergence, point of convergence. Just one second. Yes, here object. So it is point of divergence. Means from this point, all our light rays are going away. So this is now point of divergence. This is the object. Now here, image. Image, again point to light rays all are going to converge. Point of convergence. Yes, now point of divergence. Divergence of what? Incident rays. Here, point of convergence of what? Reflected rays. Yes, here divergence of incident rays. Incident rays, students, means incident rays, no, before reflection. Before incident on the mirror. That's why these are incident. Now, point of convergence of reflected means after reflection from the mirror, after reflection from the mirror. So it is related to the image, it is related to the object. Yes, now this is first now technical meaning of object and image. Now come to in-depth analysis of object and in-depth analysis of image, students. Yes, now here object. So technically it is point of divergence of incident rays. Point of divergence of incident rays is now object we know. But students, now sometimes, especially in combinations, for example, if you take now telescope or microscope, so any this type of instruments, not only a single element, not a single now lens, combinations there, lenses, mirrors, or more lenses, that combinations are. At that time, object may not be point of divergence of incident rays, students. At that sometimes, point of convergence, but remember that convergence is not real convergence. That is only now appearing only. So that's why here, some cases, apparent means not real, apparent point of convergence of incident rays is nothing but again object also. But what is the main object? Point of divergence of incident rays. That is okay. Means really that incident rays are moving away from the object. But sometimes these incident rays not now diverging, appear to converge. Incident only, but appear to converge. That is nothing but virtual object. Yes, students, here object again two types. Real object, virtual object. Yes, students, real object means really real object. Virtual object means really object not there, but object appeared there. So this type of object is known as a virtual object. I will explain clearly again, but you please remember this. Virtual object means really not there. Name itself telling it is a virtual. Really object not there. Just object is appeared to be formed. So that type of now object is a virtual object. So students, real object is nothing but point of divergence of incident. So it is really incident rays are diverging from real object. But virtual object means it is point of convergence, but not real. It is only apparent point of convergence. Apparent point of convergence. Apparent point of convergence of, again, incident rays only. Incident rays only related to our object. Once reflection will come, that is image. So that's why here, real point of divergence of incident rays, so that is a real object. Some cases that now incident rays won't now move away. That incident rays appear to converge, appear only. Really not converge, appear only. So that is a apparent point of convergence. That is nothing but a virtual object. Yes, so students, now here object, real object means really there. Virtual object means only appear, not really there. Yes, now technical meanings also complete. Now students come to here image also. Now image, students, image, it is now point of convergence of reflected rays. Means after the reflection, reflected rays all are going to converge at one particular point. That is nothing but now our image. Means that is a really converging. So that is real image. But students, in some cases, these reflected rays are not going to be converged. These reflected rays appear, not real, just appear to diverge from one particular point. So here, diverging point, but diverging point for which rays? Reflected rays. So this is now virtual image. Yes, so students, here real image is point of convergence of reflected rays means really now these reflected rays are going to be converged and finally now image is formed. That is real image. But now here sometimes apparent point of divergence means that reflected rays really not converged. These appear to diverge from one particular point, just appeared only. So that type of image is nothing but a virtual image. Yes, I hope all students now clearly understood. Yes, the nature of object and nature of the image. Yes, one small revision on that. Yes, so students now, object to image. In between object and image, one phenomenon. What is that phenomenon? Reflection. For that reflection phenomenon, we need one object. That is nothing but a element. That element is a mirror. So object to element to finally image. From object to element, incident rays involved. From element to image, reflected rays involved. Yes, students, now object to element, incident rays involved. So from object to element, incident rays moving from the object. Element to image, reflected rays involved. So now, incident rays are related to object, reflected rays are related to image. Now, these incident rays really diverging from a point. That point is nothing but real object. But sometimes, yes, in the coming classes now, in which cases this type of objects will come, also we'll know. Sometimes, incident rays, instead of moving away from a point, trying to converge at a one point, but really not converge, it is only appearing only. That is now apparent point of convergence of incident rays is known as a virtual object, means really object not there but appeared. That is a virtual object. Yes, student, this is completely related to the object. Means incident rays completed. Now coming to reflected rays side. Yes, reflected rays. So these reflected rays, that is after reflection, directly converged. Means directly converged. Image is formed. That image is nothing but real image. That image is nothing but a real image. Means real image formed. But sometimes these reflected rays are appear to diverge. That is apparent point of divergence of reflected rays. That is now known as a virtual image. So real image means really reflected rays converged. That's why image formed. Here, virtual image means really not converged. It is apparent, means appearing point of divergence. Divergence. So this is now, students, virtual image. So now object, that is nothing but point of divergence of incident rays, and now image, point of convergence of reflected rays. Yes, now already we know real and virtual. That's why point of divergence of incident rays is known as a real object. Point of convergence of reflected rays is nothing but real image. Okay. Yes, students, now technical meanings completed. Now come to, yes, this real object to virtual object to real image and virtual image in our mirrors. How that now look like now, I am going to explain. Okay, just wait one second. Yes, so students, now I am taking just one plain mirror, for example. So this is a plain mirror. This all you know. This side silvered surface. It is silvered surface. This side reflecting surface. Reflecting surface. For example, now students, this is now mirror. So this is a reflecting surface. Backside silvered surface. So that's why incident rays always should strike reflecting surface only. This point now, please now remember, incident rays always should strike only reflecting surface, not the silvered surface. Suppose now this side, backside, suppose any light rays, nothing will be happening. So that's why our reflection needs incident rays should strike on reflecting surface side, not on silvered side. Okay, this is the first. Next, yes, so here one point. This is one object. From the object, light rays are moving like this, and this light rays are nothing but a incident rays. Why? Because still this light rays not incident on the mirror. This is now before reflection. That's why these light rays are known as incident light rays. Means incident rays. So this incident rays. Now students, tell me, this incident rays appear diverging or now converging? So these all incident rays are now diverging from a point. So this is a diverging point of incident rays. So really now incident rays are diverging. So this is nothing but real object. It is the real object. Okay. Now same, now this is the real object. Now students, here another example I am taking. So this is the mirror. And incident rays are moving like this. Yes, students, now these rays are still incident rays only, because after incident, next only now reflection takes place. Still these light rays are moving towards the reflecting surface. That means still these all are incident rays only. So now these incident rays definitely not coming from particular point, because here divergence not possible. So here divergence not possible. Divergence means moving away. Convergence means towards. Okay. Yes, here divergence not possible, students. Divergence not possible. But if you extend these lines. Yes, so students, here one important point. These incident rays directly not converging. See, no, these incident rays not converging. I am just extending. See, this light ray I am extending up to here, but not possible, because here mirror is there. That means at the time of here collision, reflection takes place. But I am just now expanding only. really not possible. I am just expanding. So after expanding this all, this point, nothing but object. Why object? Because it is still related to incident rays only. That's why this is still object. But that object really not. So it is only apparent point of convergence of incident rays. So this type of object is nothing but a virtual object. Yes, students, now all clear. Now what is the real object? What is the virtual object? Real object means really object is there. From that object, all light rays are going away. Nothing but now, our object is a point of divergence of incident rays. But now coming to here, again incident rays only. But these incident rays are not diverging from any point. And of course, not converging also. But if you extend, these all rays appear only, really not converging, appear to form here one object. That's why it is only now apparent, not real. So that's why it is known as virtual object. Students, real object to virtual object to, this is now key. Right? Now coming to image also. Okay? Just wait, students. This is now real object to virtual object. Okay? Right. Now coming to image. Image is related to reflected rays, already we discussed. Now here image I am explaining means it is a mirror. From the mirror, because students, incident rays are related to object. Reflected rays are related to image. Now our target is image, means light rays should come from the mirror, because after reflection, these all are now suppose reflected rays. These reflected rays, after reflection from the mirror, these light rays are coming and definitely now here convergence pass. So this is point of convergence of reflected rays, means really converged. This is known as, students, real image. Means really converged. Really converged. So it is clear in appear. So really converged. But this rays, incident rays or reflected rays? Reflected rays. That's why it is an image. Incident rays related to object. Object already completed. So now it is the image. This is real image. Now come to students now. Another. Yes. So these all are now reflected rays. Yes. Now see students, reflected rays. So definitely this is coming like this, moving like this, moving. That means definitely these light rays never converge, no doubt. So these light rays never converge. But if you extend here, this is point of divergence. Students, now see only point of divergence, really not diverging point. After now extension only, now it is look like now diverging point. So that's why it is now virtual image. So this is virtual image. Yes, students, real image is point of convergence of reflected rays. Really reflected rays going to converge. So that is real image. But here, students, yes, this reflected rays coming from the mirror means reflected. Incident on the mirror means that is incident. So this is reflected. But these reflected rays not going to converge. Yes, but of course not diverging also. But if you extend these light rays, appearing only, just visible, appear only. That's why it is known as virtual image. So virtual image, apparent point of divergence. Yes, reflected rays related to image, incident rays related to object. So students, now real image completed, virtual image also completed. Okay, right now, clear technical meanings of object, real object and virtual object to work. And image and real image and virtual image also. Yes, so students, now one small point please write in your notebooks. Ray optics deals the relation between parameters of object and parameters of image. Next, real point of divergence of incident rays is a real object. Apparent point of convergence of incident rays treated as virtual object. And now coming to image, point of convergence of reflected rays is a real image. Apparent point of divergence of reflected rays is virtual image. Yes, now this, now in short you need to write. Again, now I will send now one small PDF file also, need not to worry. But at the time of now explanation, you need to write at least main points. Okay, students, now up to now, what is the real object? What is the virtual object? What is the real image? What is the virtual image? Clearly over. Now come to this all now, object and image, how related? Okay, just wait one second. Yes, so students, now it is a plane mirror. Yes, suppose in front of this planar mirror, suppose now one person is standing. Then definitely students, here image is formed. No? This is our daily experience. This is plane mirror. Here object now standing. Here image is formed. From our analysis, now I am going to explain. This is now object to students. This is now image form. Yes, here from the object, incident rays are going like that. Means these incident rays are moving away from the object. This object is a point of divergence of incident rays. That's why it is a real object. Now students, after incident on this mirror, yes, these rays are now going like this, reflected. But these reflected rays, this side, see now, this ray never converge. But if you extend, this image is formed. Now students, tell me, is it real point of convergence of reflected rays or only after extension, means virtual means the apparent point of divergence of reflected rays? It is not real, it is only apparent. So this image is a virtual. So for a real object, virtual image is formed in our daily plane mirror experience. So students, now in this class, ray optics are introduced and object and image. So clear technical meanings are completed. And next, further reflection. Yes, all now, how this all now object and image related. How a mirror forms now image, but not now general rough surface or general wall. And how this mirror, how much distance now images form. Yes, coming now, in-depth analysis of complete reflection in coming classes. Okay, students, now physics class completed. Yeah, just wait a few seconds.